Greetings and salutations. Welcome back to my channel. I hope everyone is having a wonderful week. Thank you all so much on the feedback and support of last week's video. It really meant a lot. So last week I said I was going to be talking about how the power went out my building and my chair had to be carried down 4 flights of stairs, but I didn't think it was fair to really share that with you just because I didn't have a lot of pictures and it's not really that exciting. But something did happen to me this past Sunday that I'm sure everyone can relate to. And before we get into it, I want to share this clip from one of my favorite movies of all time to give you some context into what I mean.
A woman in Paris was on her way to go shopping. But she had forgotten her coat, went back to get it. When she had gotten her coat, the phone had rung, so she'd stopped to answer it and talked for a couple of minutes. While the woman was on the phone, Daisy was rehearsing for a performance at the Paris Opera House. And while she was rehearsing, the woman on the phone now had gone outside to get a taxi. Now, a taxi driver had dropped off a fare earlier and had stopped to get a cup of coffee. And all the while, Daisy was rehearsing. And this cab driver, who dropped off the earlier fare and had stopped to get the cup of coffee, had picked up the lady who was going shopping and had missed getting the earlier cab. The taxi had to stop for a man crossing the street who had left for work 5 minutes later than he normally did because he forgot to set his alarm. While that man, late for work, was crossing the street, Daisy had finished rehearsing and was taking a shower. And while Daisy was showering, the taxi was waiting outside a boutique for the woman to pick up a package, which hadn't been wrapped yet because the girl who was supposed to wrap it had broken up with her boyfriend the night before and forgot. When the package was wrapped, the woman, who was back in the cab, was blocked by a delivery truck, all the while Daisy was getting dressed. The delivery truck pulled away and the taxi was able to move, while Daisy, the last to be dressed, waited for one of her friends who had broken a shoelace. While the taxi was stopped, waiting for a traffic light, Daisy and her friend came out the back of the theater. And if only one thing had happened differently, if that shoelace hadn't broken, or that delivery truck had moved moments earlier, or that package had been wrapped and ready because the girl hadn't broken up with her boyfriend, or that man had set his alarm and got up 5 minutes earlier, or that taxi driver hadn't stopped for a cup of coffee, or that woman had remembered her coat and gotten to an earlier cab, Daisy and a friend would have crossed the street, and the taxi would have driven by.
That taxi did not go by, and that driver was momentarily distracted. And that taxi hit Daisy. And her leg was crushed.
All right, so now that you've seen this clip, let me tell you what happened. I rely on public transportation to get everywhere I have to go. One, I'm legally blind, so I cannot drive. They could make an adaptive vehicle for me, but because I'm legally blind, it's just not a good idea. Now, there's no reason why I can't, because I'm sure there are several people out there that are legally blind and still drive. I have decided not to. The other reason why I take, public transportation is because, as I've mentioned in other videos, you can see a link right here, we have been trying to install a wheelchair lift into my chair coming up on 2 years, and there's been no progress. No one knows what they're doing, and it just pisses me off. If you want to see those videos, it's right here. Just click on that little, whatever it's called. Okay, so I had to get my hair done on Sunday. Because anyone that takes public transportation knows that you kind of have to plan everything out to give yourself 15 minutes in between, especially if you are taking more than one load of transportation. I had to take 2 buses to get to my hair appointment, which is only 11 miles away. Figure that. I wake up, I get on the bus. My appointment was scheduled for 11 a.m. I get on the bus at 9:30 so I can get to my first stop, which will come at 10:30, and then I'll make it to my appointment at 10:55. That is the goal, right? But here's what happened. I get to the bus stop at 9:30. Driver's not there. Okay, cool. Have to wait for the next bus, which comes in 20 minutes at 9:45. Because I missed, or the 9:30 bus did not come, I didn't get to part one of my destination until 10:30, which was when the next bus was going to get me to my destination. Had that bus been there at 9:30, I would have been to my first stop at 10:15, plenty of time to get on the next bus. And because it was a Sunday, the bus that would actually take me to my hair salon didn't come until the next hour, which was 11:30. So being the responsible person that I try to be, I called the hair salon, told them what was going on, everything's fine. I was near a Dunkin' Donuts, so I'm like, cool, let me get some coffee, let me go into Dunkin' Donuts and chill. 11:30 comes, I get on the bus, we're on our way. I told the salon that I would be there at 11:45, give or take 5 minutes. On our journey, we get to a shopping center, which is one of the stops, and there was a car blocking everyone. So everyone could get in to the shopping center, but no one could drive out because some asshole had parked their car right in the middle. So like I said, no one could pass. We're sitting there for an additional 10 minutes. The bus driver's honking. The people behind the bus are honking because they can't see around the bus to see what's going on. 10 minutes later, this jackass comes out of the, one of the stores. And the driver's like, yo, you're blocking the way. You can't do that. He looks at her and says, I don't care. Got in his car and drove away. Get to the hair salon. They call me as I'm getting off the bus and say, are you still coming? Your stylist, you know, she has other things to do in the day. And by this point, it's 12 o'clock. And I said, I'm literally across the street. Thank God everything worked out. Got my hair done, as you can see. And all is right with the world. But the point is, like I showed you in that clip from The Curious Case of Benjamin Button, had the bus driver at the beginning of the day decided to, if he had shown up like he was supposed to, I would have gotten to the bus on time. That, and because of him, I didn't get the bus on time. I had to catch the next one. And because of that one incident, everything else was like a domino effect. So the moral of the story here is, please be considerate of everybody's time. It's not a race issue, a political issue. It's a people issue. Please be considerate. Everybody has something to do. You don't know who's relying on this person or that person. So please do your part to make sure that whatever happens, you did your job. And if something bad happens in the mix, you did your part and it's not on you. And with that being said, thank you all so much for watching this week's video. I really hope you enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun making it. I'm really happy that the comments you left were in full support of me making videos once a week. And I think this new schedule will help. The stories will be more interesting because some shit is always happening either to me or I'm just witnessing something because this world is crazy. With that being said, have a wonderful day. Have an even better weekend. Please get vaccinated, especially if you live in the US. If you're not vaccinated, and you choose not to, and it's free, you're stupid. Whatever happens to you, fuck you. Have a wonderful weekend. God bless. Bye.